everyone, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight I want to read you one of my favorites. It's called The Day the Crayons Quit. And my friend Ryan, all the way out in Oakland, California, actually emailed me about this book. He thought that I might like it. He wanted to recommend it. And indeed I do, Ryan. I already know all about it. And like I said, it's kind of on my top 10 favorites list. So this is a great one to share with you tonight. One day in class, Duncan went to take out his crayons and found a stack of letters with his name on them. See, it says to Duncan. Hey, Duncan, it's me, Red Crayon. We need to talk. You make me work harder than all of your other crayons. All year long, I wear myself out coloring fire engines, apples, strawberries, and everything else that's red. I even work on holidays. I have to color all the Santas at Christmas and all the hearts on Valentine's Day. I need a rest. Your overworked friend, Red Crayon. Whew. Red Crayon wrote a letter to tell him, I'm tired. I need a break. And then there was a letter from Purple Crayon. Dear Duncan, all right, listen. I love that I'm your favorite crayon for grapes, dragons, and wizard's hats, but it makes me crazy that so much of my gorgeous color goes outside the lines. If you don't start coloring inside the lines soon, I'm going to completely lose it. Your very neat friend, Purple Crayon. Huh. He's kind of yelling at Duncan to tell him to be neater. Color inside the lines. I don't know. I think that's a pretty cool drawing, though. What do you think? Dear Duncan, I'm tired of being called light brown or dark tan, because I'm neither. I am beige and I am proud. I'm also tired of being second place to Mr. Brown Crayon. It's not fair that Brown gets all the bears, ponies, and puppies, while the only things I get are turkey dinners, if I'm lucky, and wheat. And let's be honest, when was the last time you saw a kid excited about coloring wheat? Your beige friend, Beige Crayon. Oh, and Beige Crayon's kind of feeling sad because he doesn't feel that he's used enough. You know, when Duncan's coloring, he hardly ever uses beige in his drawings. Poor Beige. Which crayon will be next, I wonder? Do you think they all wrote him letters? Yeah, I think they did. Duncan, Gray Crayon here. You're killing me. I know you love elephants, and I know that elephants are gray. But that's a lot of space to color in all by myself. And don't even get me started on your rhinos, hippos, and humpback whales. You know how tired I am after handling one of those things? Such big animals. Baby penguins are gray, you know. So are very tiny rocks. Pebbles? How about one of those once in a while to give me a break? Your very tired friend, Gray Crayon. Dear Duncan, you color with me, but why? Most of the time, I'm the same color as the page you're using me on, white. If I didn't have a black outline, you wouldn't even know I was there. I'm not even in the rainbow. I'm only used to color snow or to fill in an empty space between other things. And it leaves me feeling, well, empty. We need to talk. Your empty friend, White Crayon. So White is feeling left out. White Cat in the Snow by Duncan. Hi, Duncan. I hate being used to draw the outline of things, things that are colored in by other colors, all of which think they're brighter than me. It's not fair when you use me to draw a nice beach ball and then fill in all the colors of that beach ball with all the other crayons. How about a black beach ball sometime? Is that too much to ask? Your friend, Black Crayon. Seems like black and white are feeling the same way, right? They're feeling kind of left out. And red and gray are both saying they're too tired. They need a break. Beige was feeling left out. How do the other crayons feel? Dear Duncan, as Green Crayon, I'm writing for two reasons. One is to say that I like my workloads of crocodiles, trees, dinosaurs, and frogs. I have no problems and wish to congratulate you on a very successful coloring things green career so far. The second reason I write is for my friends, Yellow Crayon and Orange Crayon, who are no longer speaking to each other. Both crayons feel they should be the color of the sun. Please settle this soon, because they're driving the rest of us crazy. Your happy friend, Green Crayon. So green's happy, but yellow and orange seem to be arguing. Let's see if they settle it. Dear Duncan, Yellow Crayon here. I need to tell Orange Crayon that I am the color of the sun. I would tell him, but we are no longer speaking. And I can prove I'm the color of the sun, too. Last Tuesday, you used me to color in the sun on your Happy Farm coloring book. In case you've forgotten, it's on page 7. You can't miss me. I'm shining down brilliantly on a field of yellow corn. Your pal, in the true color of the sun, Yellow Crayon. Dear Duncan, I see Yellow Crayon already talked to you, the big whiner. Anyway, can you please tell Mr. Tattletale that he is not the color of the sun? I would, but we are no longer speaking. We both know I am clearly the color of the sun because on Thursday, you used me to color the sun in on both the Monkey Island and the Meet the Zookeeper pages in your Day at the Zoo coloring book. Aren't you glad I'm here? Your pal and the real color of the sun, Orange Crayon. Dear Duncan, it's been great being your favorite color this past year, and the year before, and the year before that. I have really enjoyed all those oceans, lakes, rivers, raindrops, rain clouds, and clear skies. But the bad news is that I'm so short and stubby, I can't even see over the railing in the crayon box anymore. I need a break. Your very stubby friend, Blue Crayon. Oh, he used him so much, he's gotten shorter and shorter and shorter. Duncan, listen here, kid. You have not used me once in the past year. It's because you think I'm a girl's color, isn't it? Speaking of which, please tell your little sister I said thank you for using me to color in her Little Princess coloring book. I think she did a fabulous job of staying inside the lines. Now, back to us. Could you please use me sometime to color the occasional pink dinosaur or monster or cowboy? Goodness knows they could use a splash of color. Your unused friend, Pink Crayon. Hey, Duncan. It's me, Peach Crayon. Why did you peel off all my paper wrapping? Now I'm naked and too embarrassed to leave the crayon box. I don't even have any underwear. How would you like to go to school naked? I need some clothes. Help! Your naked friend, Peach Crayon. Oh my goodness. Did you ever do that, boys and girls? Did you ever peel the wrapper off the crayon? I think I sometimes do that. Yep, so his peeling, his wrapper's all gone. Well, poor Duncan just wanted to color. And of course he wanted his crayons to be happy. And so that gave him an idea. What's he going to do? He's read all these letters from all the color of crayons in his box. What's he going to do to make them all happy? Oh, wow. Check that out. When Duncan showed his teacher his new picture, she gave him an A for coloring. Look at all the different colors on there. An A for coloring and an A plus for creativity. Let's go back and look at that picture. It is pretty creative, isn't it? Who says you can't have a pink pony, right? And why not make a whale orange instead of gray? Yeah. And Blue said he was tired. Remember, he was doing too much coloring. So Duncan instead made the sky yellow. Why not? I say great job, Duncan. Boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed that story as much as I do and as much as Ryan does out there in Oakland, California. Thanks again, Ryan, for the recommendation. We're going to end this evening with our two special lullabies, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, How I wonder what you are, up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Very good, and now our moon song. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless all you boys and girls at home. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.